Autocrafters, your source for Cougar, Falcon, Fairlane, Full-Size, Mustang, Maverick, Pinto, Ford Truck. Contact us at www.autocrafters.com.
All right, this week I'm talking about the fact that sometimes with Ford, black ain't black. This column is a perfect example of this. The column you have here in front of me is our 1972 Ford F-100 steering column. This is the original paint on this column. I can tell because it doesn't look to be retouched. It's got a nice original patina to it. So I'm pretty positive that this has not been repainted. And I know that for another fact because 99.9% of the time, if somebody's gonna go back and repaint one of these things, they'll go down and buy a can of Rust-Oleum semi-gloss black and repaint it. This color that Ford used originally was not semi-gloss black. This color was in fact a metallic black. It was this way on a lot of Ford products. A lot of people will go in and refinish interiors on these old cars, not really look at what they've got going on, and then you end up with an interior that's a much more intense black than Ford originally used back in the 60s. This color was used quite a bit on your 60s muscle cars from Ford. One thing you can do to make sure if the black on your steering column or wherever is correct is a lot of times you can take the bell off the top here. Because Ford painted the column itself separate from the bells, you'll be able to tell up inside of here what the original color was. Usually it's a metallic black. Now when I go in and I paint this, I'm going to talk a little bit about the color I used. But what I wanted to kind of go over as well is the fact that we've done some things to this column in the recent past that we didn't necessarily cover on an episode because we kind of talked about it ad nauseum over at Auto Restomod. Now we replaced the turn signal assembly on this because it was wrecked out. Canceling cams inside were in bad shape and it just needed to be redone. So we took and got another one, and basically it's the one for the Mustang or the Falcon. In fact, I have a theory that if you wanted to, say put a 5-speed on the floor in your Ford pickup truck, you could probably take the column out of a 65 Mustang or a 66 Mustang, use the upper bell on it on this neck, and end up having a perfect fit. Because the part numbers inside for this stuff are, guess what, 1964 or 65 Falcon. Okay, now I'll make a point to this of how different the blacks are. This is a black on our lead for the neutral safety switch, and you can see that that black and the black on this column do not match. This is a much more rich black. This is more of a charcoal black or a metallic black. So there you go. Now you know. So what else have we done to this column? Well, let me talk to you about that. Well, one of the things I like to use is this color called Detail Gray from the guys at Eastwood. This is a really nice product. I don't even know if they still carry this, but I'm pretty sure they do. This works great for things like your shifter mechanism down here at the other end of the column. If you're doing a dead nuts all the way into the engine bay restoration of your column, you'll want to get some of this to repaint the shift arm like we've done here. The other thing I like to use is this. The only problem I have with the Rust-Oleum metallic black is that it is a little different in color than the original metallic black. It's a little bluer, but for a rattle can system, it's not too bad. Now, there are colors available. Some of the companies carry the paints that are replicated of the originals. This is just something that's an enamel that you can do over the counter, and that's what I'm going to redo this column in, because we've got a tritone effect going on in our truck. The column is black, the dash pad's black, and the overhead headliner is black on it as well. So I'm going to take this now and I'm going to go and refinish this. I'm going to take a Scotch-Brite and clean this up, then I'm going to go in and also take and sand down these areas to make them a little less offensive to the eye. Boy, how did this thing's got a lot of offensive to the eye to it. And repaint this column and let you see what it looks like when we're done with it. Okay, so what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna go over what I do for painting procedure. I know it's not really correct, but it gets by for most of us guys in the enthusiast end of things. What I'll do is a lot of times I'll take and use some Scotch-Brite to get the stuff and the junk off the steering column itself and to kind of scuff up the existing paint. I don't wanna remove any more of the paint than I absolutely need to in order to get the job done, because if I remove more paint, that's just more stuff I've got to take care of. Now, I've got some areas on here that I'm gonna have to do more than just scuff. I'm gonna have to take these areas where I've got some chipping in the paint up in here and around the collar in order to get that to lay out nicer, if you will. Somebody put a tack, thankfully, on the column on this truck, because you know, it was a hot rod. And when they did that, they put it on there, and it basically it just chewed up the column itself. And the steel wool will go in and just grab all that mess, and any of the sticky material left, it'll knock it off. Okay, now I've gone in and cleaned everything down with the steel wool. I prefer using the Scotch-Brite. I'm out of Scotch-Brite right now. My ankle is hurt. I'm standing on one leg. You can't see it, but I am. So I will use steel wool when I lack the Scotch-Brite. The only thing I don't like about steel wool is steel wool can leave remnants around. If you get any moisture inside the cab, it will turn to rust almost immediately. So what I'm going to do is use the 180 to scuff the column down in areas where I've got chipping in the paint. I'm not going to be real aggressive with this stuff because I don't want to cut too much off of here. Now I can feel some areas in here where I've got some schmutz still from the old steering column surround they had for the tachometer. So I'm going to try to get all that up. If you don't do this just right, you'll be able to see where the old paint was. And you'll notice that there's really not, there's probably one thin layer of primer on the metal. Usually the Rust-Oleum is pretty good about that. It's pretty forgiving if you're not putting primer down. You probably should put some primer down. And if you want to, you can. I'm not going to tell anybody negative things about you. This column is pretty roughed up on the top side. That's pretty darn close to what I'm looking for right there. Now, here's what I'll say. I think you should use primer, in all honesty. Primer is a good thing because a lot of times it will etch the metal and make everything stick a little bit better, especially on a column that may or may not have seen a lot of armor all. The reason I'm not using primer on this particular application is because of expedience. I want to get this column and all back in the truck so I can get the truck back mobile again in a fairly short order. Were I doing this for a Concours or a real high-end vehicle, I would definitely go in and scuff it down really nicely, put some primer on it, and be done with it. The 180 will actually leave marks in your metal that you'll be able to see, so that's why you want to go to the 320 after you get through with the 180. Meanwhile, I'm going to keep sanding with my 180. Right now, for my final part of this, I'm going to go in and use some 320 to clean up the sanding scratches from the 180. This will give you a much finer look. Places that I've got on here that are a little less than nice, I'm going to try to get looking better. This is the underside of the column, so I'm not quite as worried about what it looks like as I am with the top of the column. And I'm also trying to go in a single direction. I want to try to kind of go with the direction of the column when I'm doing this. This is just a good chance to get all the nicks and stuff worked down on it. Hopefully this is done with enamel, because Ford like to use enamel more than lacquer on the interior and even exterior and even interior of the cars. Because if it's done with lacquer and I put enamel on top of it, it's going to craze. Something else to keep in mind of so that you can use a sealing primer on it, in case you just don't know. So I'm going to finish getting this taken care of. I'm almost done here. And then I'm going to start wrapping everything up and taping it off. And I'll just talk about that after I get it done. Okay, I've got everything taped off. It's not the prettiest tape job I've ever done, but I'm not as worried about this as I would be about some other things. And what I'm doing right now is I'm going over the steering column with a little bit of acetone to possibly clean off any residue there might be from my fingers on it. You'll notice I'm handling it by the taped areas, not by the actual metal itself. And I'm just going to go through and completely clean this thing down top to bottom with the acetone. It'll take off the residue paint that's still on there. Now what I'm trying to do with this is I am just trying to get this thing cleaned up and done. I recommend priming it. I really do. You go in, you prime it, and then you go in and paint it, and it's going to hold up a lot better probably. But at this stage, I'm going to probably be pulling this back out again, but it's going to be a little while down the road. My main goal in this is to get this done so that we can work on the wiring harness from American Auto Wire that we got through the guys here at Auto Crafters. So I'm going to get this kind of finished up. Take it out, put it on my tree, so to speak, and light it up with some paint. Let's see what we get. Well, I have to say, I am pretty astounded by how nicely this turned out. This color is probably a little bit off from the Ford metallic black that they used, but I'm going to tell you right now, it's close enough. There may be just a tad more metallic in this than the Ford black was originally, too. I'm not concerned. I mean, this is going to look really nice inside the truck. It definitely matches close enough that unless somebody just absolutely, for some reason, is obsessed with metallic black, which no one really, really seems to be, this is going to work real well. A couple other little detail-y kind of things. If you're going to be doing the column and you can do it, you might as well go ahead and get a new turn signal stock for it. We got this one from the guys at Auto Crafters to put in here. It's a nice looking piece. It's a reproduction, but it's a really nice reproduction. And if you want to, you can go in and replace the seal on this. I'm not replacing this one because the rubber's in really super nice shape. And if it's in really good shape, don't mess with it. As my daddy always told me, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. It ain't broke, I'm not fixing it. Another thing that you can do while you're working on this is just go in and clean things up. I went in and I cleaned up our neutral safety switch a little bit and got it a little nicer looking, because once it goes back in there with the brand new firewall pad, it's gonna look pretty tatty. What if your wires are in pretty bad shape? Well, one of the things that you can do that I like to do to clean these up is to go in and honestly use hand cleaner. A good pumice hand cleaner will take this wire, if it's in nasty looking shape and really discolored, and even sometimes if it has paint on it, it will go in and just make it look like new money. I haven't done anything to this one much because it's not really that bad, but if I were to do something, I would probably go in and use like an orange pumice cleaner. Like, I've got some that's 100 years old. I've had the can for forever, and I will use it to clean up factory wires to make them look nice. One of the things I will say is you may run into some problems with on your truck harness is when you put these in, I have had a real problem with getting the new wires to insert and stay inside of the Ford clip. Even if I bend the pins out, sometimes these are popping out. It's something to keep in mind of if you start having a problem with your truck not wanting to do turn signals or whatever. It could be that you've got one of these pins that has de-inserted itself from the actual clip. And I think probably part of the problem is the pins in here may be just a tad smaller than what the originals were on the backside where the clip point is. So with that, I'm going to talk about one last thing, and that is your Prindle that goes here. Ours is busted. The tabs are broken off. It usually screws into the forward piece on here. Ours is missing these tabs. I probably should have replaced it from the guys at Auto Crafters, but I failed to order one, so I don't have it to show you. But if I had a new one, it would go right here, and there are two little screws. It would screw in there, but I don't have one. Anyway, so that's our column. It looks really good. It can now be inserted into the truck. But that's our show for this week. Now be sure to go out and check out Auto Restomod. It's our other show. That show airs every week. This show tries to air every 2 weeks. Doesn't happen. But have yourself a great week. We'll see you later. Bye.